Okay, what I guess I didn't discuss while I was out sharpening is, so the reason I, when I start rolling this and I start back here and I don't come all the way to the front, and sometimes I'll do it one or two times before I even roll it completely to the front, that's because I want to try to remove a little bit more material on this conic section back here before I get to where I want to cut that clean new cutting lip. And that's because I don't want there to be any interference with this being higher than the cutting lip on this conic section. So I guess the analogy would be the relief angle on a drill bit, where you're going to cut back from that cutting lip to make sure that the heel is not going to interfere with the cutting lip entering the workpiece and actually doing the work. You know, because if this was even slightly higher, it would keep that from contacting the work. So that's the reason I do that. I didn't explain that when I was actually cutting. So I regret not filming this when I made it. The reason is I was just kind of spitballing one afternoon, and you know, just put a couple hours into making this, and so I was able to find a hole saw that was very, very close to this barrel diameter on my Cushman chuck, and it was just a little bit tight, so I was able to just come in here with a sanding drum on an electric drill and just open this up just a little bit to you know, to get that to fit. But I didn't have any hole saw that was even close to this barrel diameter, so the way I had to make that, that's why I made this out of eighth inch steel, because I could drill through that with the hole saw. There was no way I was going to do eighth inch with my circle cutter, so I chose 16th of an inch steel to do my circle cutter. And I took a couple practice cuts in plywood until I got the radius just right from the center line here to the cutting point to get it just right. I think the bit was rotated too. I've used this for something else since then. And then, you know, once I got that, then I was able to, you know, make an absolutely perfect fit for this, you know, to where I have practically no jiggle at all. And then I did the same thing with this quarter inch UHMW. You know, I used the circle cutter to cut the UHMW and the hole saw to cut the UHMW for this one, and then just trimmed it apart on the table saw. And once I got everything, I used this as my drill aligner, and I kind of clamped everything in place and just drilled everything. And the reason I made the step down here is because I wanted there to be a good place for this to lock to, you know, this wooden piece that the C-clamp fit to. And my first couple tries when I was using this, you know, here, you know, I had it at the 49 degree. I was rotating it, and I could kind of see that I was pivoting a little bit on the tool rest. So that's when I came up with this guy that, once it gets locked down and this is locked down, then the chance of it moving and rotating were really eliminated. So really, really low tech. This thing was really low tech to build. I think it cost me zero in materials. This was all just basically leftover stuff underneath my metal workbench or a little bit of UHMW that I had, I think. But you know, a couple hours and I've got something that just does a fantastic job in a much superior way than the way I was doing it before. So let's look at some actual countersinking in steel. So the first thing I'm going to do is take some drill bits, sharpen them up with the Very Super Cool Tools twist drill bit sharpening jig, punch a bunch of holes in some plate, and then we'll do some cutting with the countersinks and just see how well it works. And the beauty of this is, it doesn't matter how many holes you cut, if you start getting your edge just a little bit boogered up, like I said, if I'm doing a lot of steel fab, I just leave this set up on the bench grinder, and so I can just come back in and just in a matter of, you know, less than a minute, pop this back in the chuck, touch that conic section up, hit that lip, and get back to work without missing a beat and be able to cut perfect countersinks. But this would work with any degree countersink that you had. You know, I'm just setting it up here for the 82 degrees, you know, so if you had a 90, you would be cutting at 45s, but the jig can be set up any way for any countersink someone has. Okay, the first thing I want to do is sharpen a couple drill bits for us to punch through that plate for countersinking. So I've got my sharpening jig, the very super cool tools twist drill bit sharpening jig, and I'm going to sharpen a 5/16 and a 1/4 inch drill bit. This one's pretty trashed out. And one more touch up there. And you just want to make sure you're pretty symmetric. Just a visual inspection is all it takes. Cut with that. Nice crisp chisel point. Okay, here's a 1/4 inch. This one's not quite as in bad a shape. And that's all there is to it. Let me take this off so it doesn't rattle off. Okay, let's go to the drill press. Drill a bunch of holes in that plate.
I'm going to drill some 5/16 and some 1/4 inch holes, and then we'll just go do a bunch of countersinking and see how many holes we can get through before the countersink needs to be touched up again. We'll put a little whisper of cutting fluid on this. I guess it would be good if I tighten the bit up. This is 1/2 inch plate. See, I'm really horsing this too. I'm not being easy on it. So that's 1/2 inch plate, and that bit, that cheap bit, is just gobbling it up sharp and right. May have fractured the end of that drill bit there. We'll take a look at it here. I'll do 4 holes of 5/16. Yeah, I think I fractured the end of that cheap bit here. I fractured a hunk off. But it's going to be so easy to touch that up and sharpen it again. But I was just getting medieval on it. But that's okay. 4 holes is good enough, so we'll do 4 holes with the 1/4. And then we'll go into the quazzing and do some countersinking. Okay, I'm gonna go touch this bit up before I put it back up since I fractured that edge. Well, it took me less than a minute to get that that broken edge off of there, and I'm gonna go ahead and just cut one more 5/16 hole while I've got this here. You want to get on with your work and get your drill bit sharpened quick and lose almost no setup time. That very super cool tool's twist drill bit sharpening jig is just the ticket. Okay, we'll go into the closing now and do some and countersink these. Okay, so these are the ones I've done so far, and so let me do a little bit, a couple little bitty drill bits with this thing. Can you see that? That's gonna cut. It's gonna cut like crazy.